We already conquered Wreck-It Ralph and all of its little secrets, and I have to say, it was totally fetch.
Stop trying to make fetch happen. It's not going to happen.
But before you go to Litwack's Family Fun Center, first you need to see everything you missed in Disney's latest, Ralph Breaks the Internet.
You know it.
Let's make a video.
Just like in real life, the movie takes place almost exactly 6 years later. We know this because in Wreck-It Ralph, Litwack's sign says, Happy 5th birthday, Susie. And now if you fast forward to today in Ralph Breaks the Internet, we have it saying, Happy 11th birthday, Susie.
That's 6 years.
There's a few other things we see here in the parking lot, like it no longer promotes Walt Disney on the freeway billboard. It now says Loftus, as in Corey Loftus, the production designer. Now we're going to talk about all your favorite Easter eggs, but first I have to get this off my chest. The billboard is just the beginning of the changes that we see on the scene. Litwack sign changed as well. Now Family Fun Center is capitalized and it's red font instead of black. He installed benches out front, got rid of the lighthouse, and he even planted a bunch of trees. He literally raised the roof of his building as well. Trust me, I counted. He only had 6 rows of tiles in the first movie, and now he has 12.
That's double.
Not only did he add new streetlights in the parking lot, he removed the old ones. And apparently he used magic power before to power the building and all the arcades. Because now we see power lines run right through the parking lot. But in Wreck-It Ralph, there were no power lines. And for all of you that are defending all those errors in the comments and you're just saying, well, the power line is just for the internet. Watch closely when Vanellope and Ralph are going to the internet, you can clearly see the internet cable they are riding through. And there's also power lines going into the building. He even redid the sign by the road. If you look closely, you can clearly see the bricks have moved. Keep in mind, this is Mr. Litwack we're talking about here. You know, the guy that can't afford a $200 steering wheel because that's more than what the arcade makes in an entire year.
That's more than this game makes in a year.
And that's weird since Candy Crush is like his biggest game in the last movie. He even had signs hanging from the building.
It might be time to sell Sugar Rush for parts.
But if his average arcade is making less than $200 a year, we can expect to see Wreck-It Ralph 3 is going to be about Mr. Litwack losing his business. Because most of these changes that we saw up front would individually cost more than the entire arcade makes in a year. But hey, at least Arlo's still there. If you listen closely, Surge Protector mentioned that there hasn't been this many homeless games since Space Invaders. So then Space Invaders got shut down then, right?
Good lord, I haven't seen this many gameless characters since Space Invaders went down.
Space Invaders went down.
But if we fast forward, you can clearly see Space Invaders is still alive and well. No out of order signs and no power offs.
I hate you.
Okay, fine, I'm off the soapbox now, let's uncover some secrets. I'm gonna do my best to not mention Easter eggs that we already found in Wreck-It Ralph like Zingif or Chun-Li. So if you wanna see those, you need to go watch everything you missed in Wreck-It Ralph first, then come on back to part 2. One correction I need to point out from Wreck-It Ralph is that I was probably wrong.
You were right. I was less right.
And these two lovely ladies probably are not Belle and Princess Aurora like I thought, and they're more likely Rosalina and Daisy from Mario Kart. Thank you in the comments for kindly letting me know about the mistake. One way Mr. Litwack makes money is with the Light Scam game, which according to Mark Robber on YouTube, it's one of the most profitable games in the arcade. Which makes perfect sense is why Mr. Litwack has it parked near the front door to maximize profits with the foot traffic. But if you look closely, it's not the famous Cyclone. If you ask me, it looks like an upside down version of the Incredibles 2 logo. Not only was the outside updated, but Vanellope got an update as well.
Hello!
If you look closely at the heart candy in her hair in Wreck-It Ralph, you will see her heart is just a normal candy heart. Now we fast forward to Ralph Breaks the Internet and the candy got stamped with a hidden Mickey stamp. Inside Felix and Calhoun's apartment, they have Tetris pieces as decorative pieces on the coffee table. But if you don't drink coffee, is it still called a coffee table?
We want to report some malfeasance over by the whack-a-mole.
By the way, Ralph, it's called whack-a-troll, not whack-a-mole. In Mr. Litwack's office slash storage closet slash hot water storage room, we see a few cool Easter eggs. Mr. Litwack has the same taste in music as Mr. Big. Who's that?
They call me Mr. Pig!
He's the most feared crime boss in Tundra Town. That's Jerry Vold's music record from the limo in Zootopia. We also have Star Wars Yoda and Chewbacca collector plates on the shelf, along with the poster of Reptilia, which was Fred's costume in Big Hero 6. Anyways, let's go to the internet. Oh wait a second. Before we go, look at this, Mickey themed computer. Let's go ahead and climb into the internet. Some of the internet's most famous websites can be found here. Now, I'm not gonna name them all because that would be super boring, but some of them worth mentioning are Cisco, Yelp, DAUM, and no, that's not a slang for the bad word, it's an actual company. Then there's Snapchat, and all the movie facts over at IMDb. The best one probably.
YouTube!
But why in the world is the YouTube building smaller than Snapchat's building? Technically speaking, YouTube is the world's second largest website, Google being first. Of course, I'm probably just a little bit biased. I mean, even Pinterest has a bigger building than YouTube. Come on, people! Then there's National Geographic, which is now one of Disney's new baby pets. And Purple Mattress, which is probably going to be the bed we will see Sleeping Beauty use from here on out. Maybe that's what Grumpy Cat needs to fix his little attitude issues. Oh yeah, we can't forget Facebook's here. And Rotten Tomatoes, love them or hate them. And who invited MySpace to this party? I didn't even know they were still around. If you look at Nosemore's eyes, they're hand-drawn just like the little Maui's on Maui's chest in Moana. Speaking of Maui, in the eBay checkout line, you can see Maui's hook is on display. I'd buy that in a heartbeat. The only problem is I'm a little bit broke. Can you cover it? All I need is an account number.
What is your account number?
7.
A credit card number.
Number, right. 7.
7? 7?
Excuse me.
Sorry, no, that's your right. Ridiculous.
Get rid of belly fat using this one weird trick.
Ooh, I love weird tricks.
Sassy housewives want to meet you.
They do.
Take a closer look at Sassy Housewives. That's actually Aunt Cass from Big Hero 6. If you look closer into eBay, you can see Anna's toy horse from Frozen is in the toys and hobbies section. eBay is obviously full of secrets, and the rubber ducky behind the horse looks like it came straight out of the Snuggly Duckling in Tangled. And this unicorn behind Ralph is for sure one of the unicorns from the Bandits musical in Tangled.
Well, tell that to my frying pan.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next item up.
So this is Brian Kurlis, the 2017 World Livestock Auctioneer Champion. So basically, he's like the best auctioneer in the world.
Basically.
Also, look closer at who's selling this wheel. It's eBay seller P. Johnson, and that is an Easter egg, because Phil Johnson co-directed the movie. When Ralph finally broke the internet, we see a famous cameo to one of our own. That is YouTube's Miranda Sings. In reality, though, since they don't give YouTube a very big building, I'm thinking it's probably giving her a shout-out because she used to work for Disney, not because she's on YouTube. If you look on the shelf behind her though, you will see Miranda decorated her room with artwork from Disney short Paper Man. Now this one I might be called crazy for, but I couldn't find any other unicorn that looked like this unicorn, except for one, Rainbow Unicorn from Inside Out.
Boo!
And in case you didn't know this, Inside Out is from Pixar. You know, the other studio. Now I'm sure you caught this next one, but just in case, Abraham Lincoln is a pun to Abraham Lincoln. You know, the president. Before Ralph wrecked the internet, there was another famous game with no boundaries called Twisted Metal. We've talked about that before. And it was most famous for its ice cream truck with a scary clown on it. I think this ice cream smash was a reference to the video game. But let's slow it down a second. And in fact, let's slow it down many seconds. This homeless guy here has a coffee mug that says, "You want it when?" He was probably the best character in Zootopia. That's right, Flash had a coffee mug that said that exact same thing. But he's probably drinking decaf. Now this isn't Shank's first time being an expert driver in a movie. Shank is voiced by Gal Gadot, and she also played the character Gazelle in the Fast and Furious franchise. But probably cooler than that is the fact that she's Wonder Woman. So yeah, I think it's safe to say she knows how to handle a sword. The old original internet is covered with older internet stuff like Y2K, where everyone thought the world was gonna end, so everyone moved out into the middle of nowhere. Or the dial-up express. If you had AOL dial-up, you know, compared to today's internet speeds, it was like the slowest train on the internet.
You've got mail.
Or GeoCities, which is essentially MySpace, which is essentially what we had before Facebook, which is essentially what we had before we all turned into an orange. Over in BuzzTube, another building that's bigger than YouTube. Inside Yes's office, if you're wondering if there's Easter eggs in her office, the answer is yes. You can believe it.
Bee puns.
Let's be friends.
If you look on the wall, she has a golden YouTube play button. When Yes is going through all the viral videos trying to determine what's trending, because we all know that trending is actually just my point is that if you look at the cat sitting on the chair, you will actually see a hidden Mickey on the seat cover.
Fortnite.
And then the screaming goat is probably a reference to the famous goat, or they're making fun of Despicable Me.
Shifted into a floss.
Careful, Disney, they'll sue ya. In the building full of productive office workers that aren't stealing company time, we see all sorts of fun stuff. Like this guy's tie has R2-D2 printed on it. And if you look closely at BuzzTube's website, you can actually see Hey Hey freaking out on the boat. And the counter on the wall is San Francisco, and it's the same counter that was in Zootopia. even though just a few moments ago he had a different calendar hanging on the wall, and keep in mind this all happened in less than 8 hours. And even though he's a sloth, Flash is making his way around the office. We see another one of his coffee mugs. And if you like rooting for the bad guy, you might remember Bellwether's mug says "World's Greatest Dad," only Dad's crossed out and it says "Assistant Mayor." Well, Bellwether should probably switch mugs with this guy because his literally says the opposite. And it looks like someone got a postcard from Olaf's warm, sunny vacation.
Snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned.
But where's Olaf in the picture? He melted. Just like the world, the internet is shaped in a globe. And just like the movies, the internet is full of hidden Mickeys. One thing that annoyed Walt Disney is when he first built Disneyland, it was in the middle of nowhere. Then all these cheap rundown hotels sprung up all over the place around his happy little kingdom like cockroaches. So here's a chance for him to throw a little bit of shade at these shady hotels. There's also a version of Let It Go being played in the background as they celebrate bringing us Oh My Disney. Disney pulled out all the stops decorating Oh My Disney, and I'm going to try to point out everything that's in Oh My Disney. The obvious and the not so obvious. The spotlights are in the shape of Mickey. We have Mickeys all over the floor. That was Iron Man that you see fly by. We have Cars characters. Over here is the blue fairy from Pinocchio. In front of that is Gazelle from Zootopia. Way in the back, that might be the island from Bug's Life, but I can't really tell because it's blurry. Big Hero 6. Then there's Bambi, The Up House, The Muppet Show with Kermit the Frog, Star Wars, and an X-Wing chasing an Imperial TIE Fighter, the Death Star. Whew! Fun little fact, R2-D2 probably has the most repeat cameos than anyone else in the entire movie. You can see the Disney hat from Fantasia and also commonly found inside Disney stores, and it has film strip wrapped around it with images from other Disney movies like Lady and the Tramp or Lion King. And clearly Mickey Mouse himself is on top of the hat. Welcoming in Marvel, we have Captain America's shield and the clock tower with the pirate ship from Peter Pan, Eve, Wally's girlfriend, and they're kind enough to include Pixar with the Luxo lamp and ball. There's also glowing wallpaper from Toy Story, Buzz and Woody, Dumbo's flying around, Sleeping Beauty, Jungle Book, The Sword in the Stone, Cinderella, Steamboat Willie, the Millennium Falcon, Arlo, Baymax and Buzz, Disney Tsum Tsums, Mickey hats are everywhere, Lilo and Nani, Elsa, Elsa again. But if you ever go to any of Disney's parks, there will only be one Elsa in the entire park at any given time, because it's magical. And it wouldn't really be realistic if you saw two different Elsas in the park at the same time. So that means that this one technically is not Elsa. But in reality, it's a fan dressed up as Elsa, you know, like a cosplay. Which would also mean that this isn't actually Darth Maul, but a Disney fan dressed up like him. Just like we see Mr. Litwack's net user looks like him, how he's dressed in the real world. So the real life Elsa that we see on stage is the one that lives online, and that's called a netizen. And then the Elsa that we see in the crowd, that is a net user, because they don't live on the internet, they live in the real world. Mystery solved. And since I'm suspicious about the vibes towards Pixar, I gotta point this out here. It seems like Merida had the least amount of screen time out of all the other princesses. Oh yeah, and she's not even smiling.
Hey, easy there.
Speaking of not smiling, there's Eeyore. Survey time! Now some are going to call this cheating, but today's survey question comes right out of the movie. And you know you wanted to answer this question the second you saw it in the movie. So what would your friends describe you as? Smart, funny, kind, or brave? Also, the girl taking the quiz has Easter eggs in her bedroom. Obviously the shirt that she's wearing has the Disney castle on it. We also see a plush Mickey on the upper shelf. Then Bambi, Thumper, and Flower all on the poster. Arendelle from Frozen is actually stuck in the snow globe. Of course, Olaf in a snow globe would be cool, because we haven't seen a snowman in a snow globe before.
Hey, wanna meet my BFF? It's Wreck-It Ralph. Just click here to see his new video.
So then wait a second, are they saying if you go to Oh My Disney, you're gonna get pop-up ads?
Hey, you have a permit for that pop-up?
Never mind, that's right. We have stormtroopers blocking the pop-ups. Well, apparently it looks like they stop pop-ups just about as good as they can shoot a blaster.
Back off, pop-up!
Hey, Disney, you need to hire this dude. That's Clarabelle the cow. And unfortunately, every Disney meetup always has that one angry fan that seems to hate being a Disney fan. I don't get it. One of Disney's most favorited cartoon shoutouts here is Humphrey the Bear and Ranger Jay from In the Bag. There's Honeylemon behind the stormtroopers, and that's the front of the Small World ride. If you listen closely to the Stormtrooper, it's the Wilhelm scream. We also have Beaker from the Muppets, Thor's hammer, Winnie the Pooh, The Nightmare Before Christmas, Mickey-themed crowd control ropes, Gamora from Guardians, or at least a cosplay Gamora, obviously, 101 Dalmatians, Kylo Ren hanging out with Iron Man, Stan Lee, of course we have another R2-D2, and Judy Hopps is talking with Rocket, and he's probably complaining about how everyone's thinking he's a rabbit.
Thank you, sweet rabbit.
Here we have Grumpy with a bowl of soup and Hey-Hey going nuts. But why in the world are they serving a plate full of Night Howler balls on the snack table? Security is like non-existent in this place. Of course, we also have Pan Shadow hanging out with Tinkerbell, and it's true Nick Wilde might have gone on the good side of the force, but it looks like his old partner is still hustling the Paw Pops. And if you've ever been to Disneyland, or you always like watching people go to Disneyland on YouTube, then you know the trash cans are magical. Well, Disney finally put Push the Trash Can in a movie. Well, if it's not Push, then at least it's one of Push's friends. Give yourself a little high five because you notice the famous A113, which is literally plastered on the side of the wall. While on the other side of the door to the princess room is the Avengers room. If you look closely right here, that's Baymax walking with Fred. Inside the princess's room, the secrets don't stop. Starting off with Mushu, we see Lumiere's on one of the tables, and Jasmine's treating Rug like it's some sort of throw rug, putting furniture on it. There's also the two dolls from the beginning of Frozen, Genie's lamp, and the old Batman shows, they use transitions just like this. If you look closely at the magazine on the floor, it says Paradise, and the island in the background is Moana's Island. We got a little hide and seek going on with Pascal, he's hanging out in the room as well.
I never thought I'd get to wear a real, what's it called again? Oh yeah. Shirt.
When all the princesses get comfortable, they're all wearing shirts customized to their movie. Most of them are self-explanatory, but some of you might not understand the connection to this one. So just in case, NOLA stands for New Orleans, Louisiana, which is where Princess Tiana's from. By the way, there's another Arendelle snow globe in there. Be willing to bet they sell those in gift shops at Disney.
Product placement.
Ach, lang me yad lumdik kim me a moose nail li yad gun away a tear drop in his eye. Hey, she back me, lassie.
Uh-huh.
What did she just say?
We don't know.
We can't understand her.
She's from the other studio.
So since we can jokingly tease the other studio, I got a question for you, Disney. If the other studio is so weird, then why do we have to put your Disney short at the beginning of their movie? One thing that makes Disney and Pixar animators some of the best in the industry is that they put so much detail into all their work that we never even see. For example, this room is in a circular shape, and if you look up, you will actually see little circles representing each of the princesses. They even took time to decorate the other side behind the camera that you don't even see. Unless, of course, you look in the mirror at just the right moment for a fraction of a second. That is dedication in editing. All right, let's give the princesses a break for a second. They probably need their beauty sleep.
Let's hop along, Cassidy!
Little E-Boy calls Ralph Cassidy, referring to the famous train robber, Butch Cassidy, because he's obviously convinced that theft is the only way possible that this hobo raised $27,001 in 24 hours. When Vanellope finally finds her voice, a one-legged pigeon shows up. Call me crazy if you want, I don't care. I'm still gonna say it. This is the same famous broom that we've been seeing in all the Disney movies. And in the shopping cart, there's a toy of Fred's lizard from Big Hero 6, and also Hero's helmet. That hazmat suit is from Zootopia, and Zootopia's hazmat suit is from Breaking Bad. Now let's take a second here and look at the Hotel Lodge sign. If you look closely, it's a little character falling off the sign, but if you look really closely, they land asleep. So they're literally falling asleep. And if you really overthink it, like the animators at Disney did, it's Sleepy from the Seven Dwarfs falling asleep. Now if that doesn't kill you, this hatchet might. I mean, it almost killed Vanellope. But who threw it? I don't know who, but I know where they came from. It probably came from one of the pub thugs from the Snuggly Duckling in Tangled. How do I know this? Because the hatchet that got thrown is the same exact one that killed someone in the pub. Literally. Now for this next one, I took extra care to double check because me living in the middle of a desert, it's obvious that I'm not an expert at ocean life. And as a lot of you corrected me in the Moana video, that is a manta ray, not a stingray. And before making the video, I honestly didn't know the difference between a manta ray and a stingray.
Are you stupid or something?
But we all learn something new every day, and keeping that in mind, Disney is learning something new every day as well. So I'm not trolling here, but we do need to clear the air. In this case, it looks like Disney didn't know their own sea creatures either. The shark that we see coming out of the sewer is a great white. Now there's a lot of similarities between great whites and tiger sharks. And I probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference if one of them was swimming right up towards me. So I'm going to go off of what the movie is saying, and Shank calls this shark a great white.
Great white in the sewer.
Now another famous great white that we all know is Bruce, the shark from the iconic movie that makes me scared to even swim inside a lake. That's right, we're talking about Jaws. What I'm talking about is the license plate. The license plate that the shark has in its mouth is the Easter egg I'm talking about here. It's the same exact license plate from the movie Jaws. The problem is, Bruce the Great White didn't actually swallow the license plate. It was actually this shark, which is a tiger shark. And since I'm not good at naming sea creatures, don't take my word for it. Matt Hopper, this guy right here, he calls it a tiger shark.
Tiger shark's like a garbage can, it'll eat anything. Someone probably threw that in a river.
So this is a great Easter egg to a non-Disney movie, but the Easter egg is a little bit crap. If you look at the roadmap, Slaughter Race is named after the people of Disney. Check out the map. Johnson Street is named after Phil Johnson, who also voiced Surge Protector, as well as co-directing the movie.
There's Deja Vu.
Moore Avenue is named after the other co-director, Rich Moore. Spencer Street is named after Clark Spencer, the producer. Chen Parkway is named after Helen Mingu Chen, the associate production designer.
Nailed it.
Fritz Parkway, I don't know what that's about. Lechner Avenue is named after Matthias Lechner from Art Direction. Kursovich Street is named after Scott Kursovich, which is the visual effects supervisor. And lastly, we have Bert's Chop Shop. And no, it's not named after Bert and Ernie. It's probably named after Bert Kling, who is one of the animators. I'm willing to bet that they worked on this scene. Now, we all saw the A113 on the wall backstage, but did you see the A113 in the virus? Keep your eyes open for the disturbing font, and you'll see in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, there's a camouflage A. Then, sneaking over right next to it is a 113. Put them together, and what have you got? A113. There's a Disney sign, and a 2D Mickey sign, and this building is literally in the shape of R2-D2. Which is also bigger than the YouTube building. All in good fun, of course, even Disney can troll sometimes. If you watch closely in the credits, you can literally see a Mickey troll. And of course, another 2D Mickey. If you remember, before the movie came out, they had a trailer for the movie with a girl playing a game on her iPad, but it wasn't anywhere in the movie. Well, if you wait till the credits ended, you will see a post-credit scene addressing your little complaint.
Hey Mo, did you like the movie, sweetie?
There was a scene in the trailer that wasn't in the movie, and that makes me sad.
Aw, that's too bad. Maybe playing your game will cheer you up.
Okay. Pancake. Milkshake. Pancake. Pancake. Milkshake.
Ooh, 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 I wanna try. My turn. Pancake. Milkshake. Pancake.
Pancake, milkshake, milkshake. I'm starting to understand why people like this game. Very zen.
Hey, everybody, look what I found. More pancakes.
Sweet, let's speed it up. Pancake, 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 pancake. Eat, little bunny. Eat.
Ralph, you might want to try feeding the kitty for a little while.
No, the kitty gets the milkshake. The bunny gets the pancake.
If you made it this far, that means you enjoyed the show, so you should probably subscribe and click the little bell so you don't miss our next adventure. Let me know what movie you want to talk about next, and remember, most importantly of all, gents and gentlets, share a smile. They are contagious.
Hey, share a smile. Contagious. Can you imagine a day without smiling? That would be outrageous. Thanks for stopping by and hanging out with Crazy Nate. Make sure to leave a thumbs up if he left you feeling